I was impressed with the Ivy League. And so my preference was for some graduate school in the Ivy League. Princeton was supposed to be a wonderful place for theoretical physics, and Harvard was supposed to be very good, so those were the two places I wanted to go. I would have considered also staying at Yale, although I knew that Harvard and Princeton were probably better for modern theoretical physics. I talked with Ernie Pollard, the nuclear physicist on the faculty, who was a fellow of my college, and I think a graduate of Cambridge. And he suggested Michigan as a good place. So I thought of applying to Michigan. I'm not sure if I actually got around to filling out the application, but I did. I know I did apply to Harvard and Princeton and Yale. But there was a problem. I had signed up for a senior essay with Henry Margenau, but he assigned me a problem in ambipolar diffusion, and I understood nothing about how to tackle such a problem, how to make approximations, how to consider data, experimental data, in making suitable approximations, going back and talking with him about suggestions and so on. I had some fantastic idea that what I should do is take the equations and somehow solve them, which was absurd. I had no understanding of what a theoretical physicist would do in such a case. If I had had some understanding, I probably could have done something, or I might have been able to do something useful. But I had no idea what the context was for working on such a thing, so I actually didn't do anything. And I think that affected my record very seriously, even though my course grades were very high, and I would have been first in my class in science if I'd graduated in 47. In the last year, I took a number of very large classes. Graded where the examinations and essays were graded by graduate students and so on, and the marks just didn't get very high in those subjects. So my average went down, and I had paid no attention to things like that, but what happened was my average went down, and so I was second in science when I actually graduated in 48.
Who
But the problem, I think, was the essay, which I hadn't done. Pardon?
was first?
A mathematician. And so actually, these applications were in many cases not so successful. Princeton, I was rejected. Harvard, I was accepted, but they didn't offer me a scholarship. Or I might have gotten an assistantship, but they didn't suggest it. I presumably would have had to do something myself to get one, and I was discouraged. Later on, people told me I was refused at Harvard, but that wasn't true. I did get a letter of acceptance from Harvard, but no further encouragement to deal with the financial problems. At Yale, I was accepted in mathematics, although I had applied in physics. The mathematicians loved me.
I mean,
And
without epsilons and deltas?
well, I'd taken a lot of graduate courses in mathematics, and the mathematics professors liked me, and they thought I would be good in mathematics. I don't know if I would have been good in mathematics or not. The motivation might have been lacking to work on pure mathematics. But anyway, they liked me. They admitted me to graduate school. But the physicists didn't. The physics department at Yale didn't admit me to graduate school, presumably because of this essay matter. At least that's what I assume. I've never seen the documents. Years later, I gave a lecture at Princeton University, and I happened to mention on my visit that I hadn't been admitted to graduate school at Princeton. And Arthur Weitman and Eugene Wigner went over to the graduate college to look at the records, but my records had disappeared. So
Expunged.
we never found out what the problem was.